Good morning, church, and all our viewers. I want to wish you a very happy and victorious new year. Let's look forward to the year of 2021, expecting mighty favor, mighty blessings, and mighty breakthroughs from the Lord. And last year, 2020, have not been an easy year for many, even in the nations, but the Lord has seen us through the year of 2020 in an amazing way. And this year, 2021, let us all look forward to a great year, even as we look on to the Lord for His guidance upon our life and upon the church. Once again, I want to thank you, church, beloved FGCCI family, and all the viewers for tuning in to FGCCI Media Channel. As today, this week is the first week of the year and also the first Sunday of the year. Let us celebrate this year of 2021 with a great and powerful service this week. And the message for this week is entitled, I think all of you would have known, it's entitled, Be Strong in the Lord. This is a theme that the Lord has given for us for the year of 2021. It's a very powerful word from the Lord, which I received on December 4th morning as I seek the face of the Lord for the theme for this year. And He gave me this theme found in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10, Be strong in the Lord. Right now I want to share from 1 Samuel chapter 17 to you. Then as he talked with them, there was the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, coming up from the armies of the Philistine, and he spoke according to the same words. So David heard them, and all the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him and were dreadfully afraid. I want you to know this. The men of Israel here, he talks about not normal men. These are our soldiers. These are our fighting soldiers of King Saul. They have gone to war and they have fought. These are not cowardly men. These are supposed to be courageous and tough men. These are our fighting men. But yet when they see Goliath, that giant is so huge and so powerful in his physical stature, they fled from him. They ran from him. And the reason, because these men are strong, not in the Lord, but in themselves. They are strong in their own flesh, in their own strength, or even in their own skills. So when you see Goliath, physically, he's so tall and so big and so huge, immediately they fled from him. Unless you are strong in the Lord, then you will flee from your Goliath. That's why the theme the Lord given to us this year is Be Strong in the Lord and in the power of His might, found in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. It's so important to be strong in the Lord. Yet you can see here, and here comes King, here comes David, here comes David, who is youthful, in verse 33 of 1 Samuel chapter 17. And Saul said to David, when David wanted to fight Goliath, Saul said to him, you are not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for you are a youth. You are just a young boy, a young man. You're only a youth. And he, a man of war from his youth. Yet David, as a youth, maybe as a teenager, dared to fight Goliath because he's strong in the Lord. He's not strong in himself or in his own physical strength. He is strong in the Lord. That's why David is able to challenge Goliath and overcome him and kill Goliath because he is strong in the Lord. It's also important for this year of 2021. We must learn to be strong in the Lord. We must develop to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might, that you can overcome every Goliath that you face in your life and overcome him and overcome your Goliath. It's so important. And in the life of David, in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6, it speaks about how David is so different from others. here in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6. Now David was greatly distressed. David can also be distressed, you can see. For the people spoke of stoning him, because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and his daughters. You see, the Amalekites came and they were not around. They were somewhere else. And then the Amalekites came and took all and robbed all the possessions and even took their wives and sons and daughters and all the children away. And they just move forward. And they come back, they realize that the place Ziklag, which they leave, has been razed to the ground and everyone was missing. So they were all grieved. Even greatly was in this, even David was in distress. And yet there's something which David have learned and developed, which make him to be so strong despite of the challenges he faced, despite the situations, circumstances that he faced. And that is the following verse. But David strengthened himself in the Lord his God. David knows how to strengthen himself in the Lord when he faced insurmountable odds, when he faced Goliath, or he faced situations that is almost impossible. And I want you to know, we must learn, like King David, to strengthen ourselves in the Lord. And God can strengthen us, can empower us to overcome challenges. In fact, the Bible says all things are possible with God. With man, it is impossible. Jesus said, but all things are possible with God. And I hope this introduction to the message will bless your heart as you continue to listen to the full message that I have given on January the 1st, midnight, on New Year's Day. And I know that many have turned in on live Zoom, and many of you have not, you're celebrating with your families, and I hope this New Year's Day's message on be strong in the Lord will richly bless your heart for this year of 2021. And continue to stay tuned to the message. Thank you. So it's so important to be strong in the Lord. You must know how to strengthen yourself in the Lord. And I will just run through you briefly. You know, there are great benefits why we must be strong. If you are not strong, then you are weak. And I ask you, who wants to be weak? Lift up their hand. Everyone wants to be strong. You see, and then that needs effort. The word is be strong in the Lord. The word be means is an action word. That means you have to do something about it. You know, you have to act upon it. You know, not think about it. You know, sometimes we think we will change. We think we'll do this. We think, but we don't do. Because we think about it. We think that we are going to obey God. But in the end, we think, but we do not do. Well, very important. Here, be strong in the Lord is an action word. It means to say that we must act upon it. Hallelujah. That's why the word believe, believe is an action word. You must make a decision to believe in God's word, to trust the Lord. It's an action word. It's not a passive word. It's something that you need to act upon. Hallelujah. That's why the word is called believe. It's an action word, which I have learned by God, by the grace of God. When you act upon God's word, you dare to believe, and God will see us through. God will come and demonstrate his power to our life. That's how important to believe and to be strong is an action word. So let us not be hearers, but be doers. That's why the Bible says, don't be hearers, but be doers. Don't be talkers, but be doers. Sometimes I met Christians, they know so much, they talk, but they don't do. And years later, I talk to them, same thing. They will keep talking, but they don't act on what they know. They don't do. There's something that's not pleasing to God. The little you know, just put it into action. The little you know, just put it into action. That really pleases the heart of God. Hallelujah. So we must be strong. In Romans 15, verse 1. Let's turn to Romans 15, verse 1. I just read from you for you. We then who are strong ought to bear with the scruples of the weak and not to please ourselves. When you are strong, you can help the weak. Hallelujah. Amen. When you are strong, you can help the weak. That's why you are strong for that purpose. We are strong enough for bodybuilding. The bodybuilders are very strong. They want to, they can show all their muscle and they are very strong. But unless you are willing to help the weak, your strength means nothing. You know, unless you're willing to help the weak. We are not bodybuilders. We are meant to be servants. Hallelujah. We're meant to be servants to help the weak when we are. When God makes us to be strong, when God commands us to be strong so that we can help the weak. Because the weak cannot help the weak. If you are weak, you cannot help the weak unless you are strong. If you are sad, you go to someone who is also sad for counsel, you both end up very sad. Last time when you said, now become very sad because you are counseled by someone who is very sad. So it's so very important to be strong so that we can what? Help the weak. When you desire to help the weak, and by becoming strong, God's anointing will always come upon you when you desire to help the weak by being strong. So number one, to help the weak when we are strong, that's why it's important to become strong so that we can help the weak. Number two, if you are strong, that's why in Joshua 1:8, God said, God commanded Joshua, be strong and be of good courage. Because when you are strong, it is for your good. Amen. When you are strong, it is for our good. Because when you are strong, you feel full of joy. When you are strong, you feel full of purpose. When you are strong, you feel energetic. You know, life is full of meaning and purpose, full of hope. When someone is strong, have that kind of emotion, that kind of energy, that kind of good feelings when you know, someone is strong. If someone who is stressed, you find that first thing they are fearful, they not even get up on the bed. At one time, I was so tired of getting up from my bed because, you know, I was weak and of course of a lot of problems. So I better if I can, I just sleep through. No need to get up from the bed this morning. You know, I have that kind of thoughts. I understand how is it like. But when you are strong, you are full of hope, full of purpose. We have full of energy, hallelujah, empowered, hallelujah, to do God's work. That's why we need to be strong in the Lord. First, what are good? You feel good. When you're strong, you feel what? You feel good. I'm telling you this. You feel good when you're strong. That's why you're able to help the weak. Hallelujah. We have the joy to have numbers. Just number two, I'm just running through. When you are strong, in Joshua 1:6, in Joshua 1:6, when you are strong, then you are ready for spiritual promotion. Hallelujah. Amen. Mm-hmm. You are strong. Then God can promote you. Yeah. God can promote you. Spiritual promotion is even more important than natural promotions. You see, spiritual promotion has great blessings and mighty breakthroughs in the spiritual. So spiritual promotion is even more important. Hallelujah. Now, because when you are strong, then you enter the promised land, not stay in a wilderness. That's why the Israelites stay in the wilderness because they are weak in their thinking and they are weak in obeying the Lord. That's why they stay in the wilderness whole life rather than entering into the promised land of milk and honey. Only when you are strong, that's why before Joshua can enter the promised land, the Lord commanded him, be strong and be of good courage. Only the strong, the courageous is able to enter and partake of the blessings of the promised land. Hallelujah. Amen. When you're strong, there's great benefits. You can enter into the promised land and partake of the hundredfold blessings that the Lord has for you. And coming to end, and coming to the next part, what are the areas that we need to be strong? What are the areas that we need to be strong? Number one, in Matthew chapter 6, verse 9, it talks about the Lord's Prayer, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. You must be strong in your prayer. If you want to be strong in the Lord, number one, you must be strong in your prayer. If you are weak in your prayer, you can't be strong in the Lord. You must be strong in your prayer life, not only in the prayer. Prayer must become alive. You must be strong in your prayer life. Then you will be strong in the Lord. God can guide you in every step that you take. The Lord able to direct you in every step that you take by the grace of God. Every time I face anything, God able to guide me and direct me what to do by the grace of God. Because you need to be strong in your prayer life. And prayer has different phases, you know. It can start with called a progression. It means first you're learning to pray, you start with a decision to pray. Then you move on to suddenly you have that desire. After you pray, the desire, God garner that desire, prayer desire. And after that, you move on to, you begin to delight in prayer. Ah, when you begin to delight in prayer, you begin to move into a prayer life. That's very important. You begin to move into what? A life of prayer. Because now you are delighting in prayer. So you begin to move into a prayer life. You want to pray without people telling you to pray, without people, you know, reminding you to pray. You just, or without people telling you must come for a prayer meeting Friday or whatnot. No, you will just come. Because you delight to pray. And then we are moving into a prayer life. That's very important. That's why you move into a devotional. When you move into the prayer life, you move into a devotion with the Lord. And we always do the things that we delight. At one time, I was learning golf. You know, Pastor, you know, I was learning golf. Business time, I was learning golf. Day and night, also lumber and night, also like, yeah, hitting the thing. Yeah. My whole life, also hitting this invincible ball, you know, swing here, swing there, you know, of course, like my life like that, you know, day and night, sort of swinging this thing, the club, you know, hit here, hit there, you know, because I like it. But once prayer becomes a delight, then it becomes your life. It becomes very naturally for you. Wants to pray, wants to come in God's presence, wants to spend time with the Lord, because now you delight to be in God's presence, you know, you delight to do His will. So very important, move into a prayer life. Amen. For you to be strong in the Lord, you must move into the prayer life. Then only you can be strong and stay strong. God not only want you to be strong, God want you to stay strong. Hallelujah. Not only today you're strong, tomorrow you're weak, becomes very moody. God wants you to be strong and stay strong. You can see King David. King David is always strong in the Lord. He has so many challenges. But you can see that he's always staying strong in the Lord. Hallelujah. And I will give you some understanding how you can stay strong. Be strong and stay strong. Number two, comes to number two. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13. I did not put it here. Okay. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13. This is a very important revelation which I've received years ago. And I share it with you. When we talk about number two is renewing of your mind. You want to be strong in the Lord, you need to renew your mind. And we always quote on Romans 12, verse 2, renewing the mind, not conform to this world. But actually is 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13, that is very powerful. Rhema from I received from the Lord. You know, in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 13 says, Therefore, you see, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. The first part, therefore, gird up the loins of your mind. In those days, when you want to do some work, they will have to tie it up. Nicely, when you want to do the work, you have to any physical work, you probably have to fold up your sleeve. You know, you fold up your sleeve before you do the work. You know, do anything. You know, you fold up your work sleeve to do work, so they won't dirty your shirt or something. You know, so it's called. So here it says, gird up the loins of what of your mind. Don't let your mind take charge. Your will, you must gird up the loins of your mind. Hallelujah. Don't let it become passive. Let it guide you, especially when it's negative. You have to gird it up. You take hold of it. Hallelujah. You gird up the loins of mind. Get it ready. You know? Get it ready to receive thoughts from God. Get it ready to do the will of God. You have to gird up your mind. That's why it's so important. You have to gird it up. Get your mind ready to serve God. Early morning when you get up, you gird up your mind. I'm ready to serve God. I'm ready to do the will of God. You saw you gird up. Your mind suddenly may feel down. Gird it up. Everybody feels down. Pastor also feels down, but I won't let it linger. The only difference between those some people who feels down and don't, and some people who don't, or is the word is called linger. A lot of people let the negative thoughts linger in them. They feel down and then they don't do anything about it. The whole day also they feel down. They do not take hold of the thoughts and make them down and then cast it out and replace it. Hallelujah. When I feel down, I immediately take hold. I think, what causing me down? I cast it out and then re-gird up my loins of my mind and then renew it. Hallelujah. Praise God. It's how you deal with your negative thoughts. How you deal with your negative emotions. You don't let it linger. You can feel it a while, but you don't let it linger. But a lot of Christians, they let the negative emotion linger, you know. Linger, then it will drain you of your energy. Then you feel weak, you know. You feel that maybe you need counseling, you know. Maybe you need this and that. Actually, you need to be strong in the Lord by girding up the loins of your mind. I'm just giving you this revelation. That's number two. Number three, I'm just running through. Number three is Proverbs 18, verse 29. It's very famous. Left and down is in the power of the tongue. I call it confession of faith. If you want to be strong in the Lord, you have to confess. Learn to speak faith. Amen. Learn to speak words of faith. Hallelujah. And words of faith is manifested through encouraging words. Learn to speak in an encouraging manner. Hallelujah. Learn to speak in a positive manner. Hallelujah. Do not speak in a negative way. Speak in a positive way. Speak in an encouraging way. That's how you confess faith. Faith, man. Someone has faith, he has the spirit of encouragement. Faith always builds you up. Why it can build you up? Because it can encourage, it can really build you up. That's right. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29 says, speak words that edify and build you up. So you need to learn to confess faith. You want to be strong in the Lord? Learn to confess faith. Hallelujah. Learn to speak in an encouraging manner. Even the situation don't look encouraging, you can still speak in a very encouraging manner, because there's always a silver lining in a dark cloud somewhere. So speak in an encouraging manner. I remember when my wife was very sick. I told her, don't worry. It's only temporary. It's only temporary. If you make a choice, it's only temporary. If you do not, of course, it can be a long time, but trust in the Lord, it's only temporary. The suffering of Job is only temporary, a short while. Hallelujah. Maybe the things that you go through, you thought, you don't know how long it will last. I'm telling you, it's only temporary. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. It's only temporary. Good up the words of my mind. Speak faith. Hallelujah. Confess.
Hallelujah. Faith.
Speak encouragingly. It's only Hallelujah. Temporary. And it will be temporary. Amen. If you let it get into you, then it will just prolong. But it can be temporary when you confess faith. Faith pleases the heart of God by the words we speak. Confess faith. Learn to confess faith. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Number four. Number four is found in Proverbs 27, verse 7. Proverbs 27, this is very powerful. Proverbs 27, verse 7 says, as iron sharpens iron, so a man sharpens the countenance of his friend. If you want to be strong in the Lord, you must have inspiring fellowship. Amen. Hallelujah. Have people around you who can inspire you and who can encourage you. Amen. If you have people around you who does not inspire you, encourage you, just say bye-bye to them. Understand? But I already say bye-bye to many of my friends, you see, bye-bye to them. Because why they do not want to move on in doing the will of God, I have to say bye-bye, I have to move on. Especially when they speak words that is not encouraging. Amen. So mix with inspiring people who mix with people who inspire you. Amen. Really? I counsel someone once. You say, oh, pastor, you know, this fellow say this to me, that fellow, the other time like that, I mean, you say, I said, then why you mix with him for what? Then don't mix with him like that. You won't hear what he say to you right now. Simple, close. But he's my friend. You choose which friend you want to be. This friend don't seem to be a friend because he kept on despising you, you know, discouraging you. So why you want to make friend with these other people? Just forget about him and mix with people who encourages you. It's your choice. It's a choice to see what friends you want to mix with. You mix with a gossiper, you become a gossiper. You mix with someone who is easily angry, you become someone who become angry easily. You see now? So it's our choice. Some people, I'm telling you, some people, they have that kind of spirit. When you do something good, they'll say,
By luck one lah, you do. And you talk like that. It causes you to become down. You do something, they will try to pull you down. Don't mix with this type of people. Amen. It's your choice. Hallelujah. Speak, mix with people who will inspire you. Amen. Who will encourage you. Hallelujah. Mix with encouraging people. And you'll find that it will cause you to what? To be strong in the Lord. Hallelujah. It's your choice. Amen. It's something very important. For all them up, you have those with you, you're always able to encourage them. You call them up, they're able to speak words. Or when you're doing something well, they come and encourage you. Oh, well done, that's excellent. You encourage you, inspire you to do greater things, work for the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. There is number four. And number five. Number five is found in Matthew chapter 4, verse 4. The Lord say, but bread alone, but every word that proceeds out from the mouth of God, every word, the word is rhema. I think we all know logos and rhema. Every word that proceeds out from the mouth of God. You want to be strong in the Lord, you must learn. You must learn to receive. When you read God's word or meditate or spending time with the Lord, you must learn to receive rhema from God. Amen. Something that you need to learn. That's why I say be strong in the Lord. Something is an action word. You just don't just come passively. You have to act on it. You have to spend time to develop it. We must learn to develop to hear rhema from God. There are two things every year that's very important. I'll make it three, So, number one, the one is our, Pastor Chrissy will know, is our annual accounts auditing time. Very important because there's a deadline. If I miss a deadline, penalty is very high. So it's very important to me, certain time, August, September, I sort of spend time, October, things out. So it's something very important. I cannot take it lightly, because there's a deadline, there's a penalty, And then second one is receiving the team for the next year. If I don't receive the team for the next year, I cannot come up with anything. How to lead the church and direct the church if I don't receive the team from the Lord? I cannot just come up with a team I like. And those days when I do business, I can come up with my own team, no problem. You see, I'm my own boss, no problem. Now it's different. Now the church is the Lord and ministry is the Lord. I have to receive from the Lord. And that's not so easy as you think. You have to learn to develop the rhema from God. That's why I did not receive the team until December comes already. Normally the Lord will give me in September or October or November. This time is very late, in December. I still have not received the team. So that Friday morning, I really come early morning to see the Lord. I said, Lord, you better give me the team because I don't have time to do designing, printing, so many things needs to do. It's already December. So that morning, by the grace of God, God gave me this rhema. Be strong in the Lord, in the power. That's why I was able to immediately do the design, everything, because I received it from the Lord. It's the word of the Lord to us. Hallelujah. Then I can speak with confidence. Then I can direct the church with confidence because it's not my team. It is the Lord's team. Hallelujah. But I need to learn to develop rhema. I learn to receive rhema from God. And then you must learn to develop rhema when you're spending time with God. Learn to receive. Develop to receive rhema from God. Because every time when the rhema comes, you will apply very perfectly to your situation. That's how powerful the rhema is. When the rhema comes, you are able to apply very powerfully to the situation that you face. That's how powerful the rhema word of God is. It's just right. It's just a word in season. It just comes as right, very correctly, in a very timely, in a very perfectly. The rhema can come. It's a word in season. So you must learn to develop rhema from God. Then, just like Jesus said, then you mention not live by bread alone. When the rhema comes, it will strengthen you. You can become what? Strong in the Lord. Hallelujah. You become what? Strong in the Lord when you learn to receive rhema from the Lord. Hallelujah. And then I just possibly conclude with this. Hallelujah. And 3 John chapter 1 verse 2 say, beloved, I pray that you will prosper in all things and be in health. This one I must thank Dr. Ming La, it was 2018 he was sharing in December. I normally the time pastor don't really care too much about my physical health. I care very much about spiritual things, I just wall out, I just eat what I want. I don't really think very much about my physical diet, what I eat, I really don't think very much until that December day when Dr. Ming shared about you know, about the different bacteria lah. You need to eat fruits lah, but the bacteria eat on the fiber lah, something, you know, the good bacteria. And it caused me to think that I have not been paying attention to my body. By the grace of God, I think 2 years now, I realize that I'm much more healthier than before. Hallelujah. I have changed my taste, you know. I eat more vegetables, more fruits. I don't have vegetable or fruits. The meal is not complete, you know. And sometimes I will just eat on vegetables. And I just change my diet, man. Because I realize that you want to be strong in the Lord, you need to be strong physically. Amen. Physically, you have to be strong. Because why? You are a spirit and you have a soul, but it lives in this body. Amen. We are not in heaven yet. Okay, in heaven, we don't need this body, but we are not yet. We have not received the incorruptible body. So we need to take care of our body. If you don't take care of your body, then the body will respond in a manner that you may not like. Then you thought maybe this is a spiritual attack. Like, actually, no, it's just about we are not eating right or we are not taking care of our body. You ask Dr. Ming, I think he will give you a lot of revelations. You know, sometimes you just need to take care of your body. You will feel good about it. But this is a body that God has given to us. So we will learn to take care of it well. You know, then you feel good. When the body is feeling good, then you find out your spirit and soul, it will energize. Your good, healthy body helps to energize your spirit and your soul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you're sick, you don't feel good. Your soul also don't feel good. You don't feel like praying because your body is not well. So learn to take care of your body. Be strong in the Lord. So be strong in your body. Hallelujah. Are you getting it?
Amen.
You want to get more? You ask Dr. Ming.
Yeah.
Oh, you ask Dr. Ming. Okay, and then finally, I will close with this. Okay. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38. The pastor will close with this. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38 says, "Now the just shall live by faith, but if anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in him." This is the Lord speaking. See? "But if anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in him." Number 7, and lastly, if you want to be strong in the Lord, you need to make firm decision for the Lord and stick to it. Amen. You need to make what? Firm decision for the Lord and stick to it. A lot of people make decision for God, but in the end, they did not stick to it. You see, they did not stick to it. They did not keep to their promise that they had made to the Lord. If you want to make decision for God, learn to make it and then stick to it. Amen. Don't change. Don't waver. After the eye, then you go and do, don't waver. When you told the Lord, okay, Lord, I will take up this ministry or I'll do this, then stick to it. Don't do halfway that, maybe I should like that. God don't like, here, you're very clear. God don't like, my soul has no pleasure in him. But if anyone draws back, when you do something for God, stick to it. Amen. If not, God don't find pleasure. If we waver after a while, then we change our decision, change our. God actually don't like that. When you make a decision for God, stick to it. Amen. Stick to it. And God will be pleased. And you will really be strong in the Lord. Not in your own mind, not your own strength, but you are strong in the Lord. And no Goliath is able to overcome you. And you are able to overcome every Goliath that you face in your life or in this year of 2021. In this Pastor will close with this and let's close our eyes and bow our heads for the prayer. Father, we thank you for this year of 2021 that you have brought us, Lord, to God. Lord, we know that you have in store for us mighty favor, mighty blessings, and mighty breakthroughs. Lord, we believe, Lord, in your word. We believe, oh Lord, in your guidance and even leading, oh Lord, for your church of God. Lord, we lift up FGCCI, Lord, your church, Lord, before thy throne of grace, God. Thank you for your hand of protection. And thank you, Lord, for your hand of mighty providence upon your church. And truly, Lord, you have seen us through the year of 2020 in an amazing way. And Lord, we know that the year of 2021 will be greater blessings, mighty blessings, Lord, and mighty breakthrough that you are in store for us and for your church and everyone, God, even who is listening, oh Lord. this morning, oh Father God, in this new year's day, oh God, that they will be inspired by your word, oh God, to be strong in you and in the power of your no Goliath were able to overcome them, oh Lord, but they will shall overcome every Goliath that they face in the year of 2021 and even beyond, oh God. Father, we thank you for tonight, Lord, and thank you, Lord, for your mighty presence that is with us. Most of all, Lord, your word shall prevail in our hearts and your word shall prevail in the nations, oh God. Let your name be greatly magnified and glorified, oh God. We give you back, Lord, all the glory and all the honor and all praise that is due unto you and you alone. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I think Pastor is learning Zoom preaching. Preaching by faith. Before you clap, I just trust you clap, you laugh. My joke also not nice, so you laugh. Praise the Lord. Anyway, thank you and Happy New Year. Amen.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to everyone.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Hallelujah. And to all the pastors and leaders, awesome. Look forward to see you tomorrow for the Zoom overnight prayer. Amen.
Amen.
I will send details to you later.